I'm Corporal Donavan Gulak. I'm currently a collision reconstructionist with the RCMP and have been so for 8 years. The area that we cover on the collision reconstruction section actually goes from the BC border to the Saskatchewan border and the Wetaskiwin's detachment area to about Carstairs' detachment area. That being said, we're not limited to just collision reconstruction. We also assist IDENT and MCU with what we call forensic mapping, which is all the mapping for surveying, measuring for any major event that happens outside. For the collision reconstruction unit to respond to a call, we first get the call from the member. Now that member at the scene may not necessarily know the severity or the criteria in which we would respond to that call. So we take lots of calls and end up being calls for advice. Because if you phone me and I determine that we're not needed for that particular call, I'll still tell you to ensure that you take the measurements and or certain photographs. But once they're relaying that information to us, we determine, yeah, this is a very serious collision, or the member just has no idea, it's so catastrophic, what happened, we will respond and we'll be able to make that determination through our investigative methods. We're very fortunate on the collision reconstruction unit to have basically the latest and greatest in technology to assist us in gathering our information. From the basic scene measurements, we have robotic total stations and GPS survey instruments. And these aren't specific to collision investigation. This is what normal surveyors would use, and we use the same equipment as well. In addition to that, and one of the large benefits for us, is the utilization of drones. Now, how the drones help us is we have the capabilities of taking a photograph straight down at the scene. Once we obtain that photograph, we can then scale that photograph within our software, which really reduces the amount of surveying that's required at the scene. And it also enables us to open the road that much sooner. Because once we receive a call from a detachment and it's determined that we have to attend or that we will be attending, that scene, for all intents and purposes, is frozen until we get there. They don't touch any of the debris, they don't touch, they don't clean it up so they can open a lane, they don't remove the bodies. So that when we attend the scene and send up our drone and measure, everything is as it happened when it came to rest. And that assists us a great deal in putting the reconstructing the collision. Throughout our investigational process, we've been able to identify certain intersections that are problem intersections. So in partnership with Alberta Transportation, for instance, we've made recommendations that this intersection has to change because there's been too many collisions there. And these are the statistics, and these are the types of collisions to support this. And in my career thus far, I've seen multiple intersections change from either a two-way stop to a four-way stop, or added boulevards, additional stop signs, additional signage, additional lightage. And I believe the collision reconstruction unit was a big part of making those changes in helping identify with such accuracy the type of collisions that the current configuration was causing.